So in 2023, AI was a big deal, and it still is. And going forward in 2024, I think everybody's going to see even more advancements in AI. And Kittl's no exception. In this video, I'm going to show you what Kittl has planned. It's called AI-X1. There's a lot to see. I'm going to show you everything and what they have already that you can start using. Let's go. Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I'm excited to show you what Kittl has in store for the future with AI. It's called AI-X1. I'm gonna go to their page and show you, kind of read along what it's gonna do, some really cool stuff that they have planned. And I'm gonna show you something they have in beta right now, which is kind of a prep for the things that they're gonna do in the future. But this one actually works right now, and it's a logo maker. And I'm gonna show you step-by-step on how that works and how you can use it for print on demand. So let's go to Kittl right now, and I'll go to that page first. All right, so here we are on Kittl, kittl.com. And when you first come to this page, you'll see this thing right here, and it's gonna say introducing Kittl AI-X1. So let's click on it. So this is what it looks like. It's a limited access Kittl AI-X1. I'm gonna read some of this for you here. The first generative AI for graphic design, right? So they're incorporating graphic design. They know a lot about graphic design and layout and everything, so they're gonna use AI for it. Experience the future of graphic design with the first generative AI that transforms ideas into editable vector-based design, which is really important because a lot of times your AI stuff cannot be manipulated, right? And then boost your creativity process with an intuitive design co-pilot providing personalized support every step of the way. So it's showing some videos here. You can see make a post. So this is not a t-shirt, but if you want to make a post, and you can see it just generates different things on the fly for you. Here's a logo. This is the one we're going to actually use. Now you can replace it. Boom. Pretty cool, right? So here's the first one, or this is one that's not out yet, but this is one they have planned. It's called the Design Generator. It says a new way to design. Use text prompts to create sophisticated designs in any style. No hard skills or costs required. All you need is your imagination. And you can see some of these kind of look like t-shirt designs. Like that could be a t-shirt design. That could be a t-shirt design, right? You just have to describe it, and it's gonna do it, the text and everything, right? Because Kittl has the fonts and everything, and it's just gonna work all together. And then this one right here is called the Design Copilot, which we kind of saw here. It says a faster workflow for all designers of all levels, proven to accelerate design creation and increase artistic quality, which is really good if you wanna make a good design. Whether you're adjusting the style, format, text, or elements, just tell your Design Copilot and iterate it in seconds. So here's, as I was talking, this was going on here. You can watch it again. Use green, make the quote more happy and fun. Boom, it changes the quote, the text on the fly, right? You can change the color palette. You see the color palette change. And this is really cool because right now AI, when you talk to AI and you tell them these things, it actually, a lot of times it changes the whole thing. It doesn't just change the words. It doesn't just change the color. It's a lot of times it changes the whole thing. So if they get this to work, this is going to be really cool for AI and for design. And this is the one that is in beta right now, and we're going to try this in this video. So this is the logo generator. You can see build and scale your brand. Now you may be thinking, I do t-shirt design, not logo design, but actually some logo designs can be t-shirt designs. Here are some examples right here. And you just have to use your imagination. So whether it's for barbecue, for dad's barbecue, or you can make it more for cycling or fishing or any of the sports stuff, it can still be related to something. It doesn't have to be a name of a company. You can use words in there and change out the text. So I'm gonna show you how to do it. Let's go into generate logos here. So it's this one right here. You can see logo generator beta. And the way to find it is it's in the Kittl AI. So if I close this and open it, it usually goes to this image generator, and it's just right here, the logo generator now. So we're gonna try it out. You have some that they suggest here, so you can use any one of these as well too if you're looking to find something. I like this one, so I'm gonna select this one to try, because this could work great on t-shirts, any of these, right? Depending on the text and what you're designing it for, make sure you use the right kind of topic. But let's try this one first. Can see it already put it in here. Now you can change it to say something else. So make a handmade badge logo for my cafe called Urbanaste. I used a cup of coffee. So it doesn't have to say Urbanaste, right? You can say wake up coffee or busy mom coffee. Let's do that. And use a cup of coffee as the icon, right? So once you have it, then you can use here, generate logos. So click that. And it's gonna do four of them, just like we do with the image generator. This is the logo generator now. So it's gonna incorporate not just images, but the text with the image, right? So that's kind of the future for Kittl for AI, is creating the text and the image. And you can see right here, pretty cool, right? It's gonna replace that, that's fine. Hit replace. And you can see already here, and everything's editable. So you can make this a different font if you want. Boom, you can make it bigger if you want right here. You can even switch this out. If this isn't the one you want, but you got a nice thing here, you can come in here and just switch out the picture. So I can come in here, you know, this is just a base for it, but if I wanna come in here and have elements and look for coffee, and I find one in here that I like better, maybe I like this one better, take that one away. And then let's say I need coffee, right? Busy mom, I need coffee. Again, I can change the look of this. I can make it bigger, smaller, fill to that space. And I can change the colors too, right? Like if I didn't want this, I have these other colors in here I can try out, right? And this could be a really cool t-shirt. Like I can change, let me change that too. Maybe I want this to be more like that. Right? Busy mom, I need coffee, right? So let's try another one, see how simple this is. I'm gonna go back. Remember, you can come back here and go to a different one. Now I could use any one of these too, right? So these kind of look like t-shirt design. So I'm gonna replace, I'm gonna start a new one. We did one for mom's coffee, so now let's do one for dad's barbecue, right? So I'm gonna go back, and you can see I can just hit suggest and it will change, right? I'm gonna do instead of an outdoor badge, I'm gonna do maybe outdoor logo for a barbecue. Maybe it's for a barbecue restaurant. So now you don't actually have to, I'm gonna start all over. You don't have to have this. This suggest and description actually helps you, but if you wanna start from scratch, you can too. So let's do that. A barbecue logo with, let's do grilling utensils, and the name Dad's Barbecue. Okay, let's try that. Boom. Now look at that, see? It made some, let's go here. I'm gonna add this, let's replace this. And again, I can start here, this is a great start, and I can come in here, and if I wanna change this to another barbecue or change it to something else, I can, but it says it right here. And grilled chill joy, that's funny. 2000, Dad's Barbecue has too many B's there, but you know what? This thing's editable, so, and I can double click on it. And you can't see it, but let's move it up so we can see it here. There we go. One BBQ, easy as that, right? And we can change this again. Like if we don't like that, it doesn't look like a grill. Guess what? There's tons of grills in here. So let's do grill. And you have that. So let's take this out, put this in. Boom. And we're on our way to creating a nice dad's barbecue t-shirt. Now this can be in back, this can be in front, right? Let's move this to the front. Pretty cool, right? And we can change the colors and everything. Let's see if there's any grill utensils. Again, look how many graphics there are here for grills. Like you could totally make it look different. I could have used that grill here. I could use this and this, right? Let's do this and turn it. Look, we have it right there. It's giving us the size. It's giving us kind of the size that we need to put it here. Remove that. Look at those utensils. That's pretty cool, right? And so on. So we can start building our design here. I thought I saw some fire. This one. I'm going to put that right there, but in the background. So I can do this, send it back. You see that? Really cool, right? So play around with this. I'm not going to do the whole thing, but you can see right away, logos kind of look like t-shirts. So it's a really good thing that you can start using and kind of manipulate and make better. We can change the color again on these, like if we want it to stand out and make it white and yellow. White and red, whatever, right? This one could be red too. We already have that color here. Boom. So have fun with this. This is great. Once you have it done, it's really easy to download, right? So come on here. Make sure it's the right size though, first of all. So let's go here to settings. Its default will be 1200 by 1200, but you can make it, you can change it to 4500 to 5400. Confirm, and because this is all SVG vectors and stuff, I can make it as big as I want. Check that out. Barbecue, right? Now you gotta wanna stand, have these things stand out. So I would work on it a little bit more. This is not exactly what you may want, but let's say it is, let's say we're done. We're gonna download this, remove the background, we have that, and 4500 by 5400. And then do our PNG. Now you may wanna even add a texture to it. I'm gonna do that just cause I like having the texture that they do on here. And you can do it like this. You can see it adds that nice texture. I'm gonna do alpha mask on it so it knocks it out. And I'm gonna do clip content. Boom, right? So now when I download this, let's do it. Remove background, optimal quality, PNG. It's going to be knocked out. That part's going to be knocked out. So whatever colors in the background, like let's say this is not a black background, this is a red background or a blue background, you can see it coming through the back, right? See that? It changes. Right. Let me pull up the PNG. There it is. There's the PNG. Doesn't that look cool? Already, it looks kind of like a t-shirt. I would change these words. Grill, chill, enjoy might be something else. Maybe it's this year, you know, 2023, 2024, and you can put different things on here. So yeah, have fun with this. This is a great addition. Play around with it. You can see I instantly made it. Instead of having to go look for one, it just kind of generates the logo for you. And in the future, it's going to generate other things like t-shirt designs and postcards and other things like that. And this is just the beginning for Kittl getting started on their new AI tool, AI-X1. So that was just a taste of what Kittl does or is going to do in the future with AI-X1. That logo maker is on right now. You can test it out and try it out, and you can sign up for their AI-X1 for the future and be ready when they get the other stuff coming. I think it's going to be really cool in 2024. You're going to be able to change stuff and manipulate stuff, change text on the fly. You don't even have to type it. You can ask AI to suggest words in there for you, or suggest colors or change the colors, and it's going to be really cool. So future is going to be really bright for print on demand and AI together in 2024. I can't wait to see those things happen. If you want to see other things for Kittl, I have this Kittl playlist right here. You want to click on that. You can watch all things Kittl on my channel and learn more and more about this amazing app. Thanks again for watching, and as always guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.